शुक्लां वरभरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये रामाय रामभद्राय रामचन्द्राय वेद्यसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीतायाः पतये नमः। पूजन्तं राम रामेति मधुरं मधुराक्षरम् आरुह्य कविताशाखां वन्दे वाल्मीकिकोकिलम् अञ्जनानन्दनं वीरं जानकीशोकनाशनं कपीशमक्षहन्तारं वन्दे लङ्काभयङ्करम्। नमोस्तु रामाय सलक्ष्मणाय देव्यै च तस्यै जनकात्मजायै। नमोस्तु रुद्रेन्द्र यमानिलेभ्यो नमोस्तु चन्द्रार्क मरुद्गणेभ्यः। ओम नमः परमहंसास्वादित चरण कमल चिन्मकरन्दाय भक्तजन मानस निवासाय श्रीरामचन्द्राय। ओम सो टुडे इज आल्सो एकादशी। इट्स गुड दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग रामायणम ऑन दिस डे एज इवन वी रेगुलरली डू। And also more importantly, we are in this 19th sarga where there are many shlokams which describe the characteristic of Rama and very often quoted about him. We have seen up to, of course I have hurried, we will go back a little, but we have seen up to I think 32, 33, both of which are also some of those quotable quotes about Rama. Nachasya mahatim lakshmim rajyanasho pakarshati lokakantasya kantatvat chitarashme divakshayaha नवनम गंतुकामस्य त्यजतश्च वसुंधराम सर्वलोकातिगस्येव लक्षते चित्तविक्रिया। सो आई टोल्ड यू दिस 33rd श्लोक एस्पेशली इज ऑफन कोटेड इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ स्थितप्रज्ञ लक्षणम। द फर्स्ट टाइम आई हर्ड इट कोट इन दैट कॉन्टेक्स्ट लाइक आई सेड वाज परमार्थानंद जी इन हिज गीता भाष्यम। इन फैक्ट इन हिज ट्रांसक्रिप्ट इट्स देयर, दैट्स वेयर आई सॉ, इफ आई रिमेंबर, इन द गीता भाष्यम ट्रांसक्रिप्ट इट्स देयर। सो इट्स अ वेरी नाइस श्लोक, बोथ ऑफ देम आर वर्थ मेमोराइजिंग ऑल्सो। दिस नचास्य महतीं लक्ष्मीं राज्यनाशो राज्यनाशः अपकर्षति। सो हिज ग्रेट लक्ष्मी, दट इज हिज मुखवर्चस, हिज प्रशांतता हियर, हिज प्रसादा और हिज शांति दट इज रिफ्लेक्टेड इन हिज फेस। सो दिस राज्यनाशः न अपकर्षति, इट कुड नॉट टेक अवे दट सेरेनिटी ऑन हिज फेस, दट पीस इन हिज फेस। This great Rajyanashaha could not take it away. So this I told you is a direct inspiration for Tulsidas also, for his Prasannatam Yana Gatabhishekataha. This we also, Valmiki himself has said. So he was not excited or elated when people were praising. So when he was going to Dasharatha's palace, we saw Valmiki specifically said that everybody is praising, but for him there is no Chitta Vikriya. So that also Tulsidas seems to have taken from there. Tulsidas acknowledges Valmiki obviously. So prasannatam yana gatabhishekataha. So the mukambuja raghunandanasya mukambuja shrihi, that lakshmi of his lotus like face, the beauty of his lotus like face, it did not get excited at the news of the rajya abhisheka tathana mamlo vanavasa dukkhataha. So at the time of vanavasa dukkha news break, at that time also it did not get shrunk or anything. मुखाम्बुज श्रीहि रघुनंदनस्य मे सो सदास्तु सा मंजुला मातनोतु। सो दैट मुखाम्बुज श्रीहि, दैट सेरेनिटी ऑफ द फेस, लोटस लाइक फेस ऑफ रामा, मे इट ऑलवेज बेस्टो ऑस्पिशियसनेस अपॉन मी। सो इट इज अ प्रेयर। सो प्रेयर यूजुअली टू रामा दे डू, और टू रामास पादम दे डू, टू रामास हस्तम दे डू। सो लाइक दैट कवीज डू, यू नो, दिस इज अ प्रेयर टू रामास फेशियल ब्यूटी। So what kind of facial do today, and they go to these spas etc. and to get facial. This Rama's facial is of a different kind. It is of Sarvalokatigasyeva, Valmiki is saying. So this facial beauty or that serenity on his face is because he was a Jivan Mukta Jnani. So Sarvalokatigaha, one who has transcended this world. Sarvalokaha is so one who has transcended the entire world. So he who has transcended the world is, so he who sees the Adhishthanam, you know, the Adhishthana Sakshatkaram is transcending the world. He's a Jivan Mukta Ityarthaha. So in that sense, these shlokas are there. We will go back a little, but even here, so just like I shared some shlokas from the Sthita Prajna Lakshanam from Gita Bhashya. So from Gita, so somewhere from second chapter, 55th or 54th shloka, till the end of that chapter, we have Sthita Prajna Lakshanams described, and also because Arjuna asks, and then Krishna describes them, and also the sadhanani. So how do you attain to that sthita prajnyatvam? Both Valmiki is covering here. So what is the definition of sthita prajna? He whose mind is not disturbed at both a happy situation and not, so disturbed in the happy situation means elated, and then shrunk at the break of a unhappy situation. So that is a sthita prajna. All of you know. So because we have to discuss, I am discussing. These are not alien things to you. You see, so 56 shloka that I have shared. Dukheshu anudvigna manaha, sukheshu vigatasprahaha, vita raga bhayakrodhaha, sthita dhihi munihi uchyate. So he is a muni whose mind is not disturbed in the wake of dukkhas, and he is not and he is not excited in the wake of sukhas. He is called a muni who has sthita dhihi, so sthita prajna. So his knowledge is firm. That's the idea. So his nabram or whatever, his atmajnanam, whatever he has, it's called nishtha. So it is firm, that it is not disturbed by situation. See exactly what Rama also claims. Naham arthaparo devi lokam avastu mutsahe vidhimam rishibhistulyam vimalam dharmamastitam. Or kevalam dharmamastitam also is there. Vimalam is tilakakara's patha. This was 20th shloka on this chapter. So there he is also claiming, I am a rishi. So what does that mean? This is what it means. So sthitadhihi munihi uchyate. That is what I wanted to refer to. So many things. So yes, sarvatra nabhisnehaha tattat prapya shubha shubham. So whatever shubha and ashubha you get, he is not attached to it. So his mind is not stuck either in shubha or ashubha. Nabhinandati nadveshti. He is neither happy, excited in the wake of sukha. The same thing keeps repeating. That is the definition of sthita prajna. So this concept of not being excited at the wake of sukha and dukkha, not being disturbed or excited at the wake of sukha, has been explained already previously. Now in 33rd shloka, you see, navanam gantu kamasya. This shloka we have not seen, so I am telling now. So vanam gantu kamasya. So he has already made up his mind. Rama has made up his mind that I am going to forest. Only some formalities remain, that is to go and. So he said, I will take my mother's permission. What he means is that I will go and inform. He can't say, I will tell my mother out of respect and love for his mother. Saying, I will take my mother's permission. In fact, his mother is not going to allow him. He's going to argue against that and say, I have to go. This is my dharma. You have to remain. This is your dharma, etc. He's going to say, but out of respect, what he's telling is, I will take my mother's permission. So why am I saying this is? It doesn't mean that. So if my mother doesn't allow me, I won't go. It's not, that's not the case. So that's what I'm trying to say. On 25th shloka, he says, so yavan mataram apriche sitam cha pyanunayam yaham. So I will take my mother's permission. I will convince, console Sita also. Sitam anunayami aham. So I will console her. That is, I will tell her, don't worry, everything will be all right. In 14 years, I will come back. Such things he will say. There, of course, Sita Devi will convince him. So with Kausalya, he convinces Kausalya. There, Sita Devi convinces him. And then all three. So Lakshmana joins anyway. So it's very remarkable. The other day, I was listening to somebody speak on Ramayana, and they pointed out, and it's very true. Of course, he was a Mahatma. So Simhachala Shastri Garu is Harikatha exponent. So there is nowhere in the Ramayana where you find Rama without Lakshmana. Entire Ramayana, Rama and Lakshmana are always together. So you might find Rama without Sita, like Rama before wedding and when Sita Devi is being abducted by Ravana, etc. You might find such situations, but there will be no situation where Rama is devoid of Lakshmana. Both of them are always together. So Lakshmana also goes, as all of you know the story. So he has made up his mind. That's the idea. Vanam gantu kamasya. He who has decided to go to. So he is actually gantu kamaha, means he is, you know, he is ready to go. He is looking forward to it. Vanam gantu kamaha. And then so tasya chitta vikriya nalakshyate. So for he who decided to go to vanam. See, it's not that he is going to a picnic or anything. Vanam gantu kamasya chitta vikriya nalakshyate. And then Vasundharam Tyajatascha, he who has already given up the Vasundhara, that is, he was supposed to be the king, but he has given up on it already. To him, to such a person, Tasya Chitta Vikriya Nalakshyate. So there is no, so Nalakshyate is very important. You cannot even spot. In fact, Valmiki is going to later say in this chapter itself, even so, when he is going to Kausalya's palace, there are people around him, very close friends of Rama, people who know him personally. And then they are physically also close perhaps at that time, and nobody could spot any vikriya in his face. That Valmiki himself is going to say. So chitta vikriya nalakshyate, that lakshyate is very important. So it's not there at all and nobody can spot it. So that's the idea. Why? So how come he is able to be like that? Sarva lokatigaha iva. So sarva lokatigasya iva. So like a person who is sarva lokatigaha, that is he who has has transcended this world, that is a Jeevan Mukta. In, that is what is the spirit of Shiromani Tilakakara's commentary also, like I was telling you, Sarva Lokatikasya Iva means Jeevan Muktasya Iva. So now let us go back a little for some things. So Naham Arthaparo Devi Lokam Avastu Mutsahe Vidhimam Rishibhistulyam Vimalam Dharma Masthitam. So this Vimala Dharma, Tilakakara says on 20th shloka, Tilakakara says, Vimalam Dharmamasthitam, Tattvajnana Rupam Dharmamashritam. So I am committed to, so where is my Nishtha? So you can either be a Karmi, or you can be a Karma Yogi, or you can be a Jnani. So he is telling, my commitment is towards Jnanam. That is what he tries to say, Vimalam Dharmamashritam. I am committed towards this Vimala Dharma, which is Tattvajnana Rupa Dharma. So Tattvajnanam is presented sometimes as one dharma. That is one lifestyle here, dharma means. So like we have in Shanti Parva, you know, so Moksha Dharma Parvaha, so Apat Dharma Parvaha, and then there is one more. First it starts with that, so Raja Dharma and Apat Dharma and Moksha Dharma. So Moksha Dharma, they say. That is a lifestyle that is committed towards Jnanam. So I am committed towards that lifestyle, he says, because he has studied, you know, Yoga Vasishtam, etc. was for him. So incidentally, just today I came to know that it seems Valmi. So Yoga Vasishtam and Valmiki Ramayanam, we know there is something else called Ananda Ramayanam. So Maharaj Sri said this in some book, Adhyatma Ramayanam book. So he says there are three Ramayanams. Valmiki's, this popular Ramayanam that we are reading, is where Rama is Satta Pradhana. He is presented as Sat Pradhana. And then Jnana Pradhana is Yoga Vasishtha, and then there is something called Ananda Ramayana. So there it is Ananda Pradhana, Rama is presented, etc. He was telling. Be that as it may, so he is a Jnani, he has studied under Vasishtha, etc. Therefore, I am committed to that kind of a lifestyle. I am not committed to a lifestyle where I take to selfish motive. So Naham Arthaparo Devi, He Devi, He Mata. So He Kaikeyi, Naham Arthaparaha. I don't want to live in this world by leading a selfish life. Arthaparaha lokam avastum utsahe. So avastum means to live in this world. Arthaparasan, by leading a selfish life, I don't want to live. And then rishayaha atra tattvajnaha etena swasya sukadukhayoho samata nivritti margasthatata cha swabhaviki iti dhvanitam. So this nivritti margasthi tattvam, that is committed to a nivritti lifestyle of Rama. This commitment of Rama is swabhaviki, is very natural to him. Valmiki himself is going to use, or maybe he has already said, it is sahaja. It is sahaja means what? So it's born with him. It is innate quality of Rama to be like this, equanimous to both sukha and dukha. Even at the wake of such great difficulty, he is not disturbed at all. So this much, and then of course another quotable quote was there. So Nahyato, this is 22nd, Nahyato Dharma Charanam Kinchidasti Mahattaram Yatha Pitari Shushrusha Tasyava Vachanakriya. So there is no greater dharma than this. What is that? So Pitari Shushrusha, to serve the father. Here Pitari, you can include Mata also, to serve our parents, and then Vachanakriya, Tasyava Vachanakriya. So tasyaha va vachanakriya, you can include mother also and say her, so following her words and his words. So somebody might say, so it very valid question. In fact, Kausalya herself is going to say, so this is, so following mother's words is also your dharma. So as a mother, I am telling you, you know, don't go to the forest. We will see there that context. Anyway, so he says that there is no greater dharma than following your parents' words and serving them, etc., he says. And then one more thing is Dandakanam Mahadvanam. This was Dandakanam Mahadvanam, I think 25th. So Tatodhyaiva Gamishyami Dandakanam Mahadvanam. So therefore, so Tataha means thereafter, after taking my mother's permission, after convincing Sita, Adhyaiva, today itself, in fact, now itself I will go off to Dandakanam Mahadvanam. Why now itself? So he said, you know, so let Bharata be brought, and let he be anointed as the king, etc. He was saying, Kaikeyi was worried that perhaps if he stays, so Mahan Anayaha Syat Govinda Raja, or somebody was, Govinda Raja says there, if Rama waits till Bharata comes, then all my plans will be flopped, you know, because Bharata won't allow Rama to go to forest. Least of all, he will be somebody who will say, I will be the king in the, even while Rama is still there. That is, I won't let myself to be the king, Rama only deserves it, etc. So such things will happen, she anticipates, and she says, you go immediately now itself till you go. So very harsh words, if you think of it, she says, as long as you are here, तावन्नते पिता राम स्नास्यते भोक्षते पिवा. योर फादर एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर हियर ही इज नॉट गोइंग टू हैव बाथ और ही इज नॉट गोइंग टू ईट एनीथिंग सो यू बेटर गो नाउ इट्सेल्फ वेरी क्विकली नाउ इट्सेल्फ सो मच इन सो मेनी वर्ड्स ही सेज एंड देयरफॉर ही सेज अद्यैव गमिष्यामि नाउ इट्सेल्फ आई विल गो डोंट वरी अबाउट इट सो वेर विल ही गो दंडकानां महद्वनम बिकॉज शी सेड सो टू दंडकारण्यम यू हैव टू गो सो दिस दंडकानां महद्वनम दट कथा इज देर अर्लियर ऑल्सो दिस केम दंडकानां महद्वनम सो दंडकारण्यम एक्सेट्रा देर वॉज नॉट मेन्शन इन द कॉमेंट्री एनीवेयर हियर इट इज मेन्शन गोविंद राजा टेल्स वेरी ब्रीफली ही टेल्स द स्टोरी वाई इज इट कॉल्ड दंडकवनम सो दंडो नाम इक्ष्वाकुसुतः सो इक्ष्वाकु हैड अ सन कॉल्ड दंडः तस्य राष्ट्रम सो तो तस्य राष्ट्रम इज ही हैड अ पर्टिकुलर ही वॉज रूलिंग ओवर सम पीस ऑफ लैंड दैट इज ही हैड सम किंगडम सो दट राष्ट्रम वॉज देर शुक्रशापात पांसु वर्षेण विनाशितम सो दट किंगडम ऑफ हिज बाय द कर्स ऑफ शुक्र सो पांसु वर्षेण पांसु इज एक्चुअली सो व्हाट इज दट कॉल्ड ग्रेन्स ऑफ सैंड एक्चुअली सो पांसु यू कैन से द डस्ट ऑफ द फीट दे से यू नो पांसु So that is, so by sand, etc., you can say, or by dust. So by sand rain, it got destroyed. Pamsu Arshena Vinashitam Sat Aranyam Abhut. So when it was destroyed like that, due to the Shapa, there was a rain of sand, and then it got destroyed and got turned into an Aranyam, a great forest. Tad Rashtram Tannamna Dandakam Ityuchate. So Dandakam Vanam. So that Rashtram now, was originally Dandakam Rashtram, now it has become Dandakam Vanam. So that Dandakanam Mahadvanam means, so that great Vanam originally which was Dandakaranya, which was Dandaka kingdom, that Vanam I will go to, he is trying to say. So that was just one anecdote which I thought I should say. Okay, so much for this and then one more thing. Was 30th shloka about Lakshmana, Tam Bashpa Paripurnakshaha, Prushtatonu Jagamaha, Lakshmana Paramakruddhaha, Sumitrananda Vardhanaha. So that Lakshmanaha Paramakruddhaha is one part, this is Tilakakara is telling, he, Lakshmana became very angry. Whereas Shiromanikara etc. are saying Param Akruddhaha, extremely unangry he was also, Lakshmana. So he has taken to his brother's qualities, which Valmiki is going to say almost in the penultimate verse of this chapter. That Lakshmana has imbibed all the qualities of Rama because they have always been together, you know, there is Sangatka Asar. So, by the influence of Rama, Lakshmana also was like that. He was also experiencing a lot of anger or even if you, so let me come to that. He was also having great anger. He was also having great dukkham, but he also did not express it. So, Lakshmanaha Paramakruddhaha, if you say. So, extremely, he was also angry. Even if you give that meaning, which Tilakakara is giving, you can say he was angry, but he also did not express it. Because Valmiki is explicitly going to say that he also, Dharayan Dukkham Atmajam. So, he controlled his Dukkham. So, that Valmiki himself says. So, this anger also he controlled within himself. So, that what should I say, that spontaneity or whatever. So what should I say? That intelligence in the wake of your emotions, Lakshmana also had, like even Rama had. That was one more point. But then if you take Tilakakara's interpretation, Paramakruddhaha ityanena, Lakshmane avidya vikshepa shaktimati darshita, Ramecha nasa iti dhvanitam. So very important technical point he makes. So some Vedanta aspect you people might already know, but in case you don't know, I'm just telling you. Avidya has two shaktis. This is very famous. Vikshepa shakti and avarana shakti. So in Lakshmana, so see, what should I say? So this avarana shakti and vikshepa shakti, when you say avarana shakti goes by jnanam, vikshepa shakti might remain. So this is one way of explaining a jivan mukta. See, this comes in some prakrana granthas, etc. Upadesha Sahasri, for example, very importantly. So a question is raised. How does a Jivan Mukta continue to live or transact in this world? So he is supposed to have, so this world is supposed to be non-existing for him, etc. in the wake of his Jnanam. So many answers are given. The Paramasiddhanta is, he is not having a world or anything. In fact, there is no duality whatsoever. We are seeing like that. So that is the ultimate Siddhanta, which Shankara himself says in Aparokshanubhuti. So in some other places, he gives this example, this explanation, like in Upadesha Sahasri. So these two Shaktis, Avarana Shakti and Vikshepa Shakti. Avarana Shakti means the capability of Avidya to cover, and then Vikshepa Shakti is to project. So it has a Shakti to project. By Jnanam, what happens is this Avidya Lesha, they say. So a little of Avidya remains till what is that called? Videha Mukti doesn't happen. Even for a Jivan Mukta, Well, it's a very controversial topic, but I'm just telling you, it's just avidya lesha, a little of avidya remains because of which these transactions happen. That is, little of avidya remains means what? Prarabdha karma remains. So how do you explain that? So avarana shakti avidya loses, avidya does not cover the truth anymore. So even a jnani, as even he's interacting, he's seeing things, he knows these are all mithya that he sees, yet the vikshepa shakti continues. So even as avidya is projecting things, he is seeing it, but at the same time, because there is no avarana shakti, he sees that these are false, he sees them as mithya, and then he continues the transaction because vikshepa shakti is still operating. At the time of videha mukti, even that vikshepa shakti goes. In fact, that is what is videha mukti, that is what is death, that is for a jnani, and that is what is the loss of avidya completely, etc. That is, or you could also say as the end of prarabdha. When prarabdha ends, vikshepa shakti also goes away, his body falls down, then jnani becomes one with the akhanda chaitanyam, whatever you want to say. So if you want to call somebody as ajnani, you can say his vikshepa shakti is also operating, avarana shakti is also operating. Here what he is telling is, so lakshmanaha, so with respect to lakshmanaha, vikshepa shakti mati darshita. So with respect to lakshmana, he is also jnani, but he is getting angry. That means that some vikshepa shakti is still operating for Lakshmana, whereas Rama is, he is Shuddha Brahman. So there is no question of any avidya operating in him. That is what he is trying to say. So in Rama, there is no vikshepa shakti also. So Lakshmana is a Jivan Mukta in that sense, but Rama is, you can't even classify him as Jivan Mukta because there is no avidya operating on him in the first place at all. That is what he is trying to say. So paramakrutthaha ityanena lakshmane avidya vikshepa shakti mati darshita. See, because so some, he is also seeing this world, etc. With Rama's perspective, there is no world at all. In fact, it fits in well with the understanding that we have been, at least I have been proposing since the beginning, which is that Rama Shuddha Brahman and this Lakshmana is the Jiva. You know, that's why this Jiva, Rama and Lakshmana are always, to see this Buddhi, Chaitanyam is never available by itself for any, you know, operation, transaction, etc. So always with the Antahkaranam only it is available. So Jagrat Antahkaranam only it is available. So Lakshmana is that, it's the Jiva or the Jagrat Avastha or the Antahkaranam, whatever you want to call. So Antahkaranam might have a little of Vikshepa Shakti still remaining even as Avarana Shakti goes away. But with, from the point of view of the Shuddha Brahman, there is no Vikshepa Shakti or whatever Avarana Shakti, etc. That's all. It fits in well. I don't know if I was able to explain the point clearly, but what he tries to say is, and it gels in very well with what I have been proposing, in the sense that what I have heard from other Mahatmas, and I have been harping on that, that Rama Shuddha Chaitanyam and Lakshmana is that, you know, so he is that Antahkaranam or Jagrat Avastha, whatever you want to call. So some Vikshepa Shakti is still remaining. Some means Avidya Lesha. So little of Avidya. How much of Avidya? So Avidya, which is not powerful enough to generate another birth, but avidya that is only that much powerful to just continue these transactions. And why is it still remaining? Because prarabdha is still remaining, it has not exhausted. So, and then these questions are there in Upadesha Sahasri. Are you trying to say jnanam is less powerful than prarabdha because prarabdha remains even after jnanam? Is that what you are trying to say? So he says, you see, jnanam is not opposed to prarabdha in the sense because of prarabdham only I could get this jnanam, you know. So it is expressing its thanks. It was in my prarabdha that I come across Mahatmas in life and therefore this jnanam happened in this janma. Therefore it's being thankful and not destroying prarabdha. Such kind of explanation Shankaracharya gives. Of course, ultimate Siddhanta in Aparokshanubhuti he says, some people say like this, that this is avidya lesha is remaining. Today I am going to destroy all those explanations. He himself says in Upadesha Sahasri, then he says this is the Parama Siddhanta, that there is no whatever, you know, prarabdha or anything for a jnani. Be that as it may, that was a technical aspect. Let us come back to the story. Nachasya mahatim lakshmim rajyanashaha apakarshati. So how lokakantasya kantatvat chitarashme rivakshayaha. Chitarashmihi is moon. So he who has cool rays. Rashmi means rays. So he who has chitarashmi is moon, as opposed to sun who is, so chanda rashmi he is, so he who has hot rays. So shita rashme he kshayaha iva, like there is kshaya for moon, that is he has phases, you know. So even though there are phases to the moon, still whenever you see the moon, it is always attractive. That is, even when the moon is undergoing kshaya between Shukla Paksha, I mean in Krishna Paksha, between Amavasya to, sorry, between Paurnami to Amavasya, there is some kshaya for moon, still the moon is equally attractive. So like that, even though this Rajyanasha is happening to Rama, still he continues to be equally attractive or equally pleasing or equally pleased himself, like he always is. Lokakantasya, he who is extremely dear to everybody in this world, like even moon is, Kantatvat. So he is, because of his intrinsic nature is like that, and therefore that intrinsic nature can never be at a loss. So that is his nature, you know, nature can never have, swabhava can never have chutihi. Navanam gantukamasya tyajatascha vasundharam sarvalokatikasyeva lakshate chittavikriya. I told you the very important shloka. Now from 34 onwards, I have taken a lot of time. Pratishidhya shubham chatram vyajane cha svalankrite visarjayitva swajanam ratham paurans tatha janan. So this scene is captured in Ramanand Sagar's Ramayanam, so in Ramayana serial. So it's all Ramanand Sagar's Ramayan, basically mostly based on Ramcharitmanas, but some scenes, you know, of course Ramcharitmanas also ultimately is based on Valmiki Ramayana. What is he telling as soon as he comes out of that chamber in which Dasharatha and Kaikeyi are? Lakshmana is at the door, he also follows him, he also hears the news. So Lakshmana is inside the chamber, but at the door, you can think of it like that. Both of them came out, and then, so by that, till that moment, you know, when he came into the palace, so somebody was holding, this also we saw earlier, somebody was holding an umbrella to him. So some people were holding fans, all those people were standing outside. Now Rama said, okay, no need for any of this. So Pratishidhya Shubham Chhatram, that auspicious Chhatram, or you can say very beautiful Chhatram, Pratishidhya. Pratishidhya, he said, I don't want this anymore. I mean, he said, okay, it's okay, let it be, no need of all this. Vyajane cha Swalankrite. So very nice Vyajanams, they are nicely decorated. Vyajane, so two Vyajanams, they also Pratishidhya, that also he said, no need, he kept them aside. Visarjayitva, so Vyajane cha Visarjayitva, you can say. Swajanam Visarjayitva. So he took leave of, those people, so who are there in the chamber, and then already we have seen, he did Pradakshina to that Abhisheka Sambhara, and then, so he did Namaskara, and then he was walking away. That's the idea, Swajanam Visarjayitva, he was walking away from there. Ratham Paurans Tatha Janan. So he gave up that exceedingly beautiful Ratham, which was specifically brought for him. That Ratham also he gave away. So Pauran Tatha Janan, so Swajanam, his well-wishers, Pauran, so all those Purasthaha Janan, so Pauran Janan, you can say all people assembled there, all of them, he just passed away from there. That's the idea. He just kept them aside, means what? He abandoned them, means what? So he took leave from them and he went away. So that is what he's trying to say. So one more point I wanted to make earlier, when that so he did Pradakshinam to that all those Abhisheka Sambharas, etc. are there. There seems to be, so if I can find that, yeah, Abhishekam Bhandam, 31st Shloka, there seems to be a print mistake, I think, in Govinda Raja's commentary as explained here, as printed here, because he says, if I'm able to point, so should have been a print mistake. What he says is, So when he's doing Pradakshinam, Rama is praying and doing Pradakshinam. So what is he praying? He is praying, for other commentators are saying, he is praying that may Bharata be anointed by these things. May these be of use to Bharata. So that is what he is praying for. Here, I think Govinda Raja's commentary in this book, so it says, may these not be of use to Bharata. Such a prayer he is making, it looks like that. I am not able to spot exactly. So that should have been a print mistake, as far as I know. If I'm able to spot, maybe I could have told you. And then, sapekshaha, one word is there in shloka 31st. Please bear with me, I'm going back, please don't mind. Sapekshaha is there. Sapekshaha there means, yeah, see, I found that now. Sapekshaha, bharatasya anena na abhisheko astu iti prarthana sahitaha shanehi jagama. So anena abhishekaha astu, it should have been there. It's printed as nabhishekostu. That na could have been a print mistake. It should have been abhishekostu. So let me also correct it here. So abhishekostu. Okay. Now, so sapekshaha there means, so it's not even a factor in his life anymore. That's the meaning of sapekshaha. So it's a trinaprayaha, we say. So it's equal to trinam for him. It's equal to just a blade of grass. It doesn't mean anything for him. Very easily he could give up all that, you know. So earlier, when he looked at those, when he was passing by also, he looked at those things which Valmiki described. At that time, he must have thought, okay, these are the sambharams with which they are going to anoint me. Now, very easily, he just looked, okay, these are the sambarams with which Bharata is going to be anointed. He could very easily give up on that drishti. So, sapekshaha drishtim tatra avichalayan. This sapekshaha, another meaning which I told in the last class, which is also there here. Sapekshaha also means that, so his apeksha or his intention was something else. His intention was to go to the forest. Therefore, these things don't mean anything to him anymore. That is also one meaning. प्रतिषिध्य शुभम छत्रम व्यजने च स्वलंकृते विसर्जयित्वा स्वजनम रथम पौरांस तथा जनान. सो आफ्टर डूइंग ऑल दिस, आफ्टर गिविंग अप ऑन द छत्रम, आफ्टर गिविंग अप ऑन द व्यजने, द टू फैंस, एंड देन आफ्टर टेकिंग लीव फ्रॉम दोज पीपल, एंड देन आफ्टर गिविंग अप ऑन द रथ एटसेट्रा. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड? धारयन मनसा दुःखम इंद्रियाणि निगृह्य च प्रविवेश आत्मवान वेश्म मातुरप्रियशम शिवान. So dharayan manasa dukham. So what is this dukham? So the dukham he kept within himself. Dharayan manasa dukham. So here commentators are explaining in one way. I will tell you that also. So and another possible meaning. So dukham manasa dharayan. Now what is that dukham that he is withholding in his mind, in his heart? That is the dukham. So commentators are saying this dukham is, so the dukkham that by his absence people are going to experience. So now if Rama goes away, he knows that Ayodhya Puri expects him to be the king. If he goes away, then these people will experience a lot of dukkham. That is one explanation that they are giving. And then the dukkham that his mother would experience, etc. All that he's thinking, and he keeps it within himself only. Even when that dukkha is coming to his mind, he is not getting disturbed. That is the crux anyway. The dukkha is coming up, but he is controlling it within the mind, and that he is not showing off externally. The point of contention is, what is that dukkham? Is it dukkham that he is feeling about the kingdom, or like the commentators are saying, it is the dukkham that he is thinking about the others. What will happen to others? They might be in great sorrow. So all these explanations are based only. I mean, later Valmiki also is going to suggest something. So even that explanation is very fine given the context and all that. So that dukkham that he is thinking, what will happen to these people when I go away, etc. That dukkham is coming out, but he is that also manasa dharayan. So he has that enough antahkarana, you know, that or whatever, control over his antahkarana, that it's not overpowering him. He's saying, okay, let it be so. So this dharayan manasa dukkham, next chapter also something like that is going to come. Govindaraja points out there, is so what is that he points out? So vyasaneshu manushyanam bhrisham bhavati dukkhitaha. This we saw in Ayodhya Kanda second chapter 40th verse. So vyasaneshu manushyanam, so utsaveshu cha sarveshu piteva paritushyati. This we saw, that is Rama for himself there is no sukham or dukkham, but when some dukkham is coming upon people, he becomes extremely sorrowful. And when there is some utsava for people, that is when there is some cause for happiness for people, piteva paritushyati, like a father becomes happy, he also becomes happy. That we saw was one of the gunams of Rama. So Govindaraja in this context, a similar shloka is going to come in the next chapter. There he says, if this quality of Rama is being expressed here or showed. So this is why Rama was described like that. Vyasaneshu manushyanam bhrisham bhavati dukkhitaha. So vyasana there means dukkham. Some apada has come. In the context of apada or dukkham for another person, Rama becomes extremely sorrow for them. I mean, he becomes saddened for it, for their dukkha. So that is what he is telling here, dukkham. So dukkham manasa dharayan, how is he able to do? Indriyani nigrihyacha, by controlling his indriyas. Pravivesha atmavan, how is he able to control his indriyas? Because he is atmavan. So atmavan ko jitakrodhaha, we have seen earlier. So those qualities. So in the first chapter in Balakanda itself, it came Atmavan kaha jitakrodhaha. These were some of the qualities that Valmiki asked for. So one of the 16 qualities that he asked was, who is an Atmavan? So that Atmavan is coming here. At the wake of such a harsh news also, he is in control. That is Atmavan. So Atmavan. So Matuhu Veshma Pravivesha. So he entered the palace of his mother. Apriya Shamsivan. So desirous of telling her the bad news or the sad news, Loka Drishtya Apriyam, that is all right, Apriya Shamsivan. So he who is desirous of conveying this news to his mother, he that Rama entered the palace of his mother. That is one interpretation. Shiromani Kara, very nicely, what he does is Dharayan Manasa Adukham. He puts an Avagraha there. I told you olden days in manuscripts you don't find the Avagraha. In today's printing, etc., we are using that S kind of symbol, you know, that Avagraha. So he says, Manasa adukham dharayan. So adukham he's holding in his mind. Now what is this adukham? So adukham, deva dukha nivartaka yatnam dharayan chintayan. So dharayan here means, so he's thinking about the deva dukha nivartana. Nivartaka, so nivartaka yatnam. So adukham is, it's very easy for him to remove the deva dukkha which is being caused by Ravana. So that purpose he is keeping in his mind. That is his interpretation. I would say, so going by further, so going by little ahead of these shlokas, what Valmiki is telling, these people have given this meaning, that dukkham of the others he is taking. So and in his mind, and even then he is not being, you know, overpowered by the dukkham and saying, okay, people are going to be troubled. They might deal with it. Let's see what happens. So he is not still disturbed. So that meaning they are giving. But as I have always been saying, Rama later when he opens up to Lakshmana, so I don't know how these commentators are going to explain there. I have never seen these commentaries earlier. So where there they might have some explanation. I don't know. So Lakshmana, he opens up to, he says, see, such an obedient son, such a good son I am. I have so many good gunas. Will a father ever give up on such a son, listening to a woman, etc.? So he is going to open up there. So what he is saying is that dukkham is there, but it's not expressing. See, that is what is, so it's there in the sthita prajna lakshanams also. So that is to have the indriyas under control. So that he has. So that is enough for sthita prajna. Puja Swamiji also says, so what is the quality of a jnanam? His reaction time is reduced. So that is how, so I don't know how to put it now, the exact words also I'm not able to remember. So the intensity and the reaction time reduces. The dukkham comes, so he says, so the jnani's difference is, so FIR is Paramarthandaji's term. So I don't remember, frequency, intensity and something of response, something like that. FIR is Paramarthandaji's term. So Puja Swamiji, response time. Yeah. So Puja Swamiji gives a story of this person, it seems. So he had great ships, etc. in his, so he was a very wealthy merchant. Somebody comes and tells him the news that your ships with all the wealth that was supposed to come to India, so it was supposed to come, so it got drowned. So he says, what? And immediately says, so what? And then somebody comes and tells, your wife also drowned in that, so what? And so what? Your children also drowned, what? And so what? So the minimum, most minimum time he takes between what and so what, that is the characteristic of jnani. So this is that dukkham is coming, because obviously that antahkaranam, you know, he is also naturally a human being, that dukkham is coming, but still it doesn't overpower him. He is immediately able to say, no, this is not the occasion for it, etc. In fact, for the last shloka of this comment of this chapter, they are going to say, this is not the time. So Valmiki also says, here Rama did not express dukkham. So my interpretation for that here would be that later, when it is, you know, not a situation where others, so here if Rama expresses dukkham, so others also would be disturbed. If Rama is being a little strong, others, they are in dukkham, okay. If Rama also starts crying, then what will happen to others? That he keeps in mind, and here that dukkham he does not express. That's the idea. So dharayan manasa dukkham, you can, in my very humble opinion, as much take as there was dukkham, but he didn't let it out. It was there, and he thought this is not the appropriate time. He was still in control. That is the most important thing. So nigrihya indriyani and then atmavan. So despite that dukkham being there, he was still in control. It was not overpowering him. So if you take it this way, then it's a little inspiring. So if you take it as adukham, then of course it's not any more relevant to us. And dharayan manasa dukham, other people's dukham he's thinking of, and he's still in, you know, still not getting disturbed because of that also, okay. But if you take it this way, in my humble opinion, it's of some help. So let us try to finish at least this sarga now. Sarvopyabhijana Shriman Shrimata Satyavadinaha Nalakshayata Ramasya Kanchidakaramanane. So this is the shloka I was telling you. So sarvopi, or Abhijanaha, so all his well-wishers, his close friends, etc., Sarvopi, all of them. So Shriman Sarva. So Shriman is actually an adjective to Sarvaha. Shriman Sarvaha means everybody who is very nicely dressed up, decorated, etc. Because it is Rama's Pattabhishekam day, everybody is nicely dressed up and ready. So they're all nicely alankrita there. So Abhijanaha, Sarvaha, Shriman, Abhijanaha. श्रीमान अभिजनः यू कैन टेक एज एन एडजेक्टिव ऑफ अभिजनः हिज क्लोज फ्रेंड एटसेट्रा हु वेयर देयर यू नो बिटवीन दैट पैलेस एंड कौसल्यास पैलेस एंड रामास पैलेस सो मेनी पीपल हैव ऑलरेडी गैदर्ड ऑल ऑफ देम सो श्रीमतः सत्यवादिनः रामस्य आनने कंचिद आकारम न अलक्षयत आनने आकारम आकारम हियर मीन्स विकारम ओके सो एनी मॉडिफिकेशन कंचिदपि आकारम नो एनी मॉडिफिकेशन इन हिज फेस न अलक्षयत दे कुड नॉट स्पॉट एनी विकार इन हिज फेस इन फैक्ट तिलककार ऑर समबडी सेज सो व्हाई डिड दे नॉट स्पॉट बिकॉज इट वाज नॉट देयर इज नथिंग टू स्पॉट देयर सो विकृताकारम न अलक्षयत असत्वादेव बिकॉज इट वाज नॉट देयर देयरफॉर देयर इज नथिंग टू स्पॉट सो इन द फेस ऑफ हूम सत्यवादिनः सत्यवादिनः मीन्स सो दैट रामा हू इज सत्यवादी इन हिज फेस श्रीमतः श्रीमतः इज सो ही इज ऑल्सो वेरी नाइसली डेकोरेटेड एटसेट्रा श्रीमतः सो नथिंग स्पेसिफिक फॉर श्रीमतः बट श्रीमान देयर मीन्स सो श्रीमान अभिजनः सो श्रीमतः ही इज ऑल्सो यू नो सो और यू कैन से मुख श्रीमतः एटसेट्रा ही हैज दैट सेरेनिटी इन हिज फेस दैट रामा हू वाज सेरीन हू वाज अ सत्यवादी दैट रामास इन दैट रामास फेस सो देर वॉज नो विकारा एंड नो बडी कुड स्पॉट इट बिकॉज इट वॉज नॉट देर उचितं च महाबाहुर्नजहौ हर्षमात्मवान् शारद समुदीर्णांशुश्चन्द्रस्तेज इवात्मजम् सो फॉर दट 35th श्लोक तिलककर सेज समथिंग आई फॉरगॉट टू से मनसा दुःखं धारयन् इंद्रियाणि निगृह्य मनस्थ दुःखाभिव्यञ्जक चेष्टारहितानि कृत्वा आत्मवान् धीरोदात्तः मनसा दुःखं सो एटसेट्रा सो इट्स द सेम थिंग सो दट दुःखं दट वॉज देयर सो ही नेवर लेट इट ओवरपावर हिम दट्स व्हाट ही इज ट्राइंग टू से And then dukkham ityasya, another meaning could be manasa dukkham dharayan. Like I said, adukkham is one meaning that Shiromani Kara is telling. Here, Tilaka Kara says dukkham is dukkham of other people. Or it could be the dukkham which laukika drishtya it is dukkham for Rama. So people expect Rama to be dukkhita by that news. Such kind of dukkham he did not let overpower. One more beautiful meaning he says, very appropriate to Rama's quality, that is he is telling that, so he is thinking of, ayo, this Kaikeyi told like this, but what will people now think of Kaikeyi, they might blame her, etc. So, and then some internal meaning you can take. So she was just doing my purpose, my avatara purpose was for me to kill Ravana, for which I have to go to forest, which Kaikeyi, you know, she was just playing along. So she served my purpose, but still people are going to curse her, etc. That dukkham he was thinking about. So dukkham ityasya. कैकेय लोकापवादजम् इत्यर्थः इति कश्चित् सम पीपल आर सेइंग तिलककरा सोने सम पीपल आर इंटरप्रेटिंग हियर दैट हियर दुःखम मींस द लोकापवाद और द इंसल्ट ऑफ द पीपल दैट कैकेयी हैज टू अंडरगो दैट ही इज थिंकिंग एंड ही इज यू नो ओके अयो कैकेयी इज गोइंग टू फील हैज टू फेस दिस एटसेट्रा ही इज फीलिंग इन हिज माइंड एनीवे नाउ कम टू दिस 37 श्लोक उचितं च महाबाहुः नजहौ हर्षम आत्मवान् So this Mahabahu Atmavan, this Rama of, you know, long arms, that is this valiant Rama and Atmavan. Atmavan is Rama who is in control of himself. So Uchitam na jahau. So Uchitam here means so Sahajam. It is very Uchitam means Sahaja Sattva Guno Uchitam Vanagamana Labho Chitancha. So this Jahau Harsham, this Uchitam Harsham. Very appropriate harsham. That is harsham here you take as equanimity. You should not say Rama is laughing at, you know, he's elated at the news of going to the forest, etc. Harsham here means so that equanimity, that poise, that is one meaning. That poise which is uchitam, which is sahajam for him. Because why is it sahajam? Because he is sahaja sattva guna uchitam. So it is very appropriate for his sattva guna mind. So it is very appropriate that he remains in balance. That na jahau he did not give up. That serenity, that peace he did not give up. And then harsham, another meaning could be vanagamana labhochitam. So uchitam harsham means. So now you can take as excitement. The excitement that Rama is showing towards going to the forest. That natural excitement he did not give. Why is it natural to him? Because that is his purpose, avatara purpose he is solving. So that uchitam harsham. So that uchitam harsham for us we can take uchitam harsham means so that that harsha which he has made natural to him by cultivating this indriya nigraha etc. So that harsha Rama did not give up. Sharada. So for that he is giving an example. Sharada samudirnamshu chandrasteja ivatmajam. This sharadaha samudirnamshaha chandraha. Chandraha of the Sharad Rutu. Sharad Rutu sun moon is supposed to be exceedingly beautiful. They say it's the closest point of in the moon's axis to around the earth. the closest point to earth, they say something like that. I don't know exactly, but Sharadaha Chandraha, they say, is very exceedingly beautiful and very close, it appears, they say. And then Samudir Nam Shuhu. So Chandra, whose rays are nicely extending everywhere. So very bright Chandraha of the Sharad Ritu. So Atmadam Atmajam Tejaha. So this his very natural innate Teja. Teja here is beauty. So that, like Chandra doesn't give up, like that Rama also, this Harsham, this serenity which is very natural to him, he did not give up to, so give up on that. Vacha Madhuraya Rama Sarvam Sammanayan Janam Matu Samipam Dharmatma Pravivesha Mahayashaha. So this is again another, you know, Valmiki is harping on irony. From here onwards, a lot of irony will be shown and a lot of dukkham, etc. will come. So here he's saying, even in the wake of such a catastrophe, etc., when he's entering Kausalya's palace, when people are greeting him, he's greeting them back, you know. So because that is Rama's quality. What is that quality? So Smita Purvabhi Bhashi cha Purva Bhashi Priyam Madaha. So that Smita Purvabhi Bhashanam, Purvabhi Bhashanam, he's showing here. Vacha Madhuraya Ramaha Sarvam Sammanayan Janam. Sammanayan means here, so there he's nicely respecting them, acknowledging those people, those Janam that are there in that Kausalya's palace. Madhuraya Vacha, by very sweet words. Even as he's entering the palace, there are people around and then they are talking to him, saying, Rama, today is your Pattabhisheka, etc., or greetings to you, etc., they are conveying. And even in that context, he's still speaking to them sweetly. Vacha Madhuraya Sarvam Sammanayan, Sarvam Janam Sammanayan, that Ramaha, what did he do? Matus Samipam Pravivesha, that Dharmatma Ramaha, Mahayashaha Ramaha, Matus Samipam Pravivesha. Matus Samipam here means Matu palace, the palace of the mother. Pravivesha, he entered, or he entered the proximity of his mother. Not yet. So in the next chapter, again a little going back in the story will happen. And then ultimately going to Kausalya Devi, we'll see there, Matuhu Samipam, this Dharmatma, this Mahayashaha, great, exceedingly famous Rama, Pravivesha, he entered. Tam Gunai Samatam Prapto Bhrata Vipulavikramaha Saumitri Ranuvavraja Dharayan Dukham Atmajam. So Tam Gunaihi Samatam Praptaha, this is what I was telling him, Gunaihi Samatam Praptaha Bhrata Saumitrihi. This Saumitri, Sumitranandanaha, here Sumitranandana means Lakshmana, because Shatrughna is not around. This Shatrughna, who Sumitra, Saumitrihi, so Bhrata, the brother of Rama, Gunaihi Samatam Praptaha. So he has acquired equality with Rama with respect to his Gunas. So Gunaihi Ramasya Samatam Praptaha, you can take that way. Vipula Vikramaha, so he is Lakshmana of great fame, that is the idea, Vipula Vikramaha, great prowess, etc., that Saumitrihi. Tam means Ramam, Tam Ramam Anuvavraja, that Rama, this Saumitri also followed. That Rama means what? That Rama who is not disturbed even in the wake of such a catastrophe. Lakshmana also equally did not express his you know, that disturbance and his anger, he did not express. And then that Rama, so that Lakshmana, dukkham atmajam dukkham dharayan, so he also did not let that dukkham overpower him, he also contained it. Dharayan actually means contain, so he contained it within himself. And tam ramam anuvavraja, he also kept following Rama. Rama is now walking from Kaikeyi's palace to Kausalya's palace, he is walking, so he followed him. Tam gunai, so that is over. Tam gunai samatam prapto bhrata vipulavikramaha Saumitri Ranu Avraj Dharayan Dukham Atmajam. So let me just see if I missed anything here. Yeah, nothing. Okay. Yeah, so for that 38th shloka, I said it, but I'm just reading out from Govinda Raja's commentary one line. Etadrsha Durdashayamapi, even in the wake of such a catastrophe, Ramaitritva Rupam Rama Shabdartham Prakatayati. Even at the wake of such a catastrophe, Rama is being true to his name. So Rama means what? Ramayati Ti Ramaha. He who makes people happy. So he is Rama. So at the wake of such a catastrophe also, Madhuraya Vacha Sarvam Janam Sammanayan Matuhu Samipam Pravivesha. So as even he is acknowledging them by sweet words, etc., he is entering the palace, means what? At the wake of such a catastrophe also, he is being true to his Swarupa. That is what he is being said now. And then 40th shloka, Pravishya Veshmati Bhrishammudayutam Samikshatam Chartha Vipatti Magatam. अचैव रामोत्र जगाम विक्रियां सुहृज्जनस्यात्म विपत्तिशंकया स्वप्रविश्य वेश्म अतिभृशं मुदायुतम। सो अतिभृशं मुदायुतम मीन्स सो विद दैट एक्सट्रीम हैप्पीनेस सो दैट सो ही इज गोइंग टू हिज मदर ही इज गोइंग टू फॉलो हिज फादर्स वर्ड्स एटसेट्रा विद दैट हैप्पीनेस। So Veshma Pravishya, so having entered that Veshma, the residence, the palace, Mudayutam, Samikshyatam Artha Vipatti Magatam. So Tam Artha Vipatti Magatam. So that Artha Vipatti, Laukika Drishtya, it is Artha Vipatti. That is Artha Vipatti is a danger to his Artha, that is danger to his well-being, that is his loss of the kingdom. So that danger, Artha Vipattim Agatam Samikshya. Samikshya means he is thinking about the loss that he is now, you know, quote unquote suffering, that is the loss he has to face, the loss of the kingdom, that samikshya artha vipattim agatam. Agatam is very important. He didn't ask for either the kingdom or for this. It just came to him. The kingdom came to him. One day, yesterday, his father called and said, Rama, tomorrow I'm going to make you the Yuvaraja. And then today, the same Dasharatha is telling Rama in as many words. He didn't say it directly. But he is saying that Rama, you have to go to forest. So that is Agatam is very important. This Artha Vipatti has come to him. See, in life situations come to us. We don't say if it were under our control, we would have not wished for it also. But some situations just come and fall upon us. So this Agata, you can take that way. It has come and befallen upon him. That Artha Vipatti Samiksha, he is thinking about, he is examining it. Nachaiva Ramotra Jagama Vikriyam. So this Atra, I told you, Atra, here Rama did not have any vikriya. Here Rama did not express any vikriya. You can take that way. Nachaiva eva is very important. Rama chitta vikriyam najagama eva. He did not obtain any disturbance in his mind atra here. By suhrjanasyatma vipatti shankaya is a very, very important word Valmiki is putting here. Why Rama is not disturbed here in Ayodhya? Why is he not disturbed? Because he is worried that perhaps if I show some disturbance here, that is some dukkham if I express, there could be suhrijanasya atma vipatti shankaya. He has this shanka, he has this doubt, he has this apprehension that my suhrijanas, that is my well-wishers, including or beginning from mother Sumitra Devi and his friends, etc., atma vipatti, there could be some threat to them if he feels sorrow. If he expresses sorrow. Now, what could be this threat, etc.? Rama is going to open up to Lakshmana later that maybe Bharata will not take care of my mother and your mother. Dasharatha might not take care of my mother and your mother. All that he is going to say. But commentators, what they are saying is, so Atma Vipatti is the Dukkham that they are going to experience. So he is thinking that if I myself express sorrow, what will happen to them? So we say in situations, right, there are some people who, so they will say, okay, if I also, so if I, so people say also in assuaging some people, if you also become like this, what will happen? So if you become like this, what will happen to your children? You should look at your children and you should be strong, etc. They say like that. So that's what Rama is also thinking. If I also express sorrow, what will happen to these people? There will be dukkham here. Vipatti, you can say, there is dukkham for them also. So with that apprehension that if I also express sorrow, they might feel sorrowful, even more sorrowful. Therefore, let me not express any dukkham here. Like that he thought, and then therefore nobody could spot any dukkham. In fact, you will see in the next chapter, you will be amazed. So when Valmiki goes back a little and then he comes back to Kausalya's palace, people are looking at him and still they are wishing him. So even Kausalya Devi is going to say after looking at Rama, she is not able to spot any dukkham till actually he breaks the news. Nobody knows yet, you know. He is only having to go and tell to Kausalya. So that is the nature of Rama, that no disturbance he could ever show in his face. Of course, there is dukkham. He knows what the consequences are, but it doesn't overpower him. Why is he able to do that? Because of his Indriya Nigraha. But then that Indriya Nigraha, why is he operating here ultimately? Because it is Dharma. Due to his commitment to Dharma, he is operating on his Indriya Nigraha and he is not, you know, shying away from the consequences, that is the Dukkham, etc. He is not exhibiting. Pravishya Veshmati Bhrisham Mudayutam Samikshatam Chartha Vipattimagatam Achaiva Ramotra Jagama Vikriyam Suhrijanasyatma Vipattishankaya. So this is one meaning. Shiromanikara gives one more meaning, that is Artha vipattim artha vipattim arthasya paramapurushartasya राम संयोगस्येत्यर्थः। सो दिस अर्थ विपत्तिम आगताम इस फॉर कौसल्या देवी। सो विपत्तिम अभावम आगताम प्राप्ताम इव ताम कौसल्याम अतिभृशम अत्यंतम समीक्ष्य च अत्र अस्मिन् दर्शने अपि विक्रियाम चित्त विकाराभासं न जगाम। सो अर्थ विपत्तिम आगताम दिस अर्थ इज परम पुरुषार्थ विच इज टू बी इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ रामा। सो दट इज अ ग्रेट हैप्पीनेस फॉर कौसल्या। देर इज नाउ गोइंग टू बी अभाव फॉर दट Rama Sanyoga, to be in the presence of Rama for Kausalya, and then she might feel Dukkha because of that. There will be so Atma Vipatti for her, and even after looking at Kausalya, so when you see, so when you are extremely sad, when you look at your mother, till then you might control it very nicely. As soon as you see your mother, you know that opens up, that Dukkham comes out. So even after looking at his mother also, that Dukkham did not come out. Such kind of interpretation he is giving. So that is one thing, and then स्वविक्रियास्फुरणे दिस इज गोविंद राजा स्वविक्रियास्फुरणे सुहृज्जनो नश्येदिति शंकया स्वविक्रियां राज्यनाशजां नादर्शेदित्यर्थः। सो इफ ही शोस विक्रिया देन हिज सुहृज्जनास आल्सो विल हैव नाशा। नाउ व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज दिस नाशा दैट ही इज अप्रिहेंसिव अबाउट? दे विल आल्सो गेट लॉट ऑफ दुख। दैट कुड बी वन नाशा और देर कुड बी सम ट्रबल फॉर देम। सो फ्रॉम सम थ्रेट फॉर देम फ्रॉम भरता दशरथ एटसेट्रा। So that also you can say. See, that is not very apparent here. That's going to come later when he opens up to Lakshmana. Keeping that in mind, I'm giving these kind of, let's say, unconventional, at least from the point of view of the commentaries, unconventional meaning. But anyway, so Rama, the crux is, even at the face of such a catastrophe, Rama is not expressing any chitta vikriya. So it's not that the dukkham is not there. It is there, but he's not letting it overpower him. That is Rama's quality of being Atmavan. Atmavan kaha vitakrodhaha. We have seen Valmiki's requisite qualities which he asked from Narada for a person who has such qualities. And this is very nicely being brought about in this chapter. Ityarshe Srimad Ramayane Valmikiye Adi Kavye Ayodhya Kande Ekona Vimshas Sargaha. So my idea was to finish up till at least 15-16 shlokas of the next chapter. But anyway, we could not go there. That's all right. I will stop here by just stating this much that, you know, so situations come and this is one, of course, it might be very difficult for us to reach that level of, what should I say, serenity like Rama, but it is always an ideal that we can aspire to. And always with having an ideal is we should not feel guilty when you are not able to do that. What you should do or what we should do when we are not able to achieve that is just pray to Ishvara, saying, okay, my mind is still, you know, so very nice shloka and Shivananda and Hari. Sada moha tavyam vrajati yuvati nam kuchagirau natatyasha shakha swatati jhatiti svairam abhitaha kapalin bhiksho me hridaya kapi matyanta chapalam. So hey bhiksho, hey kapalin me hridaya kapi hi, this monkey mind of mine. You know, moderns, there is a book that I have called Taming the Monkey Mind. So that taming the monkey mind, Shankaracharya used that expression in Shivananda Lahari. So kapalin bhiksho me hridaya kapim atyanta chapalam dridham bhaktya badhva shiva bhavad adhinam kuru vibho. Hey vibho, hey Shiva, hey Lord. So you tie this monkey mind of mine with your bhakti and you keep it under your control. That we can always pray. Today being Ekadashi, let me also tell you that one shloka which comes as part of Ram Nam Sankirtana of Ramakrishna Mission. That shloka is of Tulsidas. So Tulsidas, like I have been saying, and you people must be knowing also that for every at the beginning of every kanda, he writes some shlokas in Sanskrit. So this very famous shloka, so it comes as one of the invocatory verses for Sundara Kanda. So what is that shloka? After saying so much, I forgot. What is the shloka? So नान्यास पुरहा रघुपते हृदयेस्मदीये सत्यं वदामि च भवान अखिलांतरात्मा भक्तिं प्रयच्छ रघुपुंगव निर्भरामे कामादि दोष रहितं कुरु मानसंच। सो इन फैक्ट आई वांटेड टू मेक दिस वन ऑफ द ध्यान श्लोकास और व्हाटएवर द इन्वोकेटरी वर्सेस फॉर आवर क्लासेस बट आई कुड नॉट डू इट बिकॉज़ आई डिड नॉट डू इट बिकॉज़ इट वुड बी अ लिटिल फेक ऑन माय पार्ट एज इन व्हाट द श्लोका सेज इज हे रघुपते न अन्यास पृहा देर इज नो अदर थॉट इन माई माइंड हे रामा एक्सेप्ट यू एंड आई एम नॉट इवन चीटिंग आई एम नॉट जोकिंग और आई एम नॉट लाइंग दैट आई डोंट हैव एनी थॉट आई नो यू आर माई अंतर्यामी सो यू नो वेन आई मीन इट एज अ ट्रूथ यू नो इट सो भवान अखिलांतरात्मा सत्यम वदामी भवान अखिलांतरात्मा आई एम टेलिंग यू द ट्रूथ दैट आई हैव नो अदर थॉट thought in my mind, and you are the antaryami. See, this I might be disturbed, so I am often disturbed by sounds here and there, etc. Therefore, I didn't want to make it. So more importantly, kamadi dosha rahitam kuru manasam cha. So my mind, hey Rama, please make it free of kama krodha, etc. All these disturbances, make it free of it. Kamadi dosha rahitam kuru manasam cha. Bhaktim prayachha raghupungava nirbharam me kamadi dosha rahitam kuru. So bhaktim prayachha. So you grant me bhakti. Raghupungava nirbharam bhakti. So that bhakti, that is, you know, it doesn't fade away. It's always strong. It is always directed towards you. Such kind of bhakti prayachha, please grant unto me. And then cleanse my mind of all these kama krodha and all these arishat vargas, we say, you know. So this prayer is what helps us. So you keep that ideal. In fact, like I've said, and you people know, Shankara says in the Stita Pratnya Lakshanam's commentary, why is it this being mentioned now? Because these lakshanams are something, Stita Pratnya's lakshanams are natural to the Jivan Mukta, and for a sadhaka, it is something that we can aspire to. To just say one more point and end. So Shankara says, I have Bhagavad Gita Bhashyam with me. I can take it out and read, but I'm sparing you of that effort. That when very beautiful line, I think it comes in the Tanstitikshasva Bharata, in that shloka. There Shankara says, see, this is the ideal of the Twamapi Tattvadarshinam Bhavam Ashritya Titikshasva. Like that something Shankara says, you also assume that attitude that the Tattvadarshis have. For them it is natural, but hey Arjuna, you transact all that he says there. You also live in this world, do the thing that you have to do, but you keep that as your ideal. You keep that as the goal and you try to imbibe it and live it like that. So this is something that we can learn from this very important chapter of Rama, a chapter that we can actually go back to often, and then even the subsequent chapter is like that. So I just thought I will say that. See, Swami Vivekananda's Karma Yoga is also based on that. He says his goal of life is knowledge, and that you keep as the ideal and you work, etc. So Karma Yoga is very extremely based on Bhagavad Gita. So people make some, say, the four yogas thing and all that. So the way Vivekananda saw it and the way people are accusing him of, it's quite different. Anyway, that's a different topic. So something I want to end on, something that I already said, that is, let us keep Rama's life as ideal in this situation. So life is going to have all these sukha and dukha, etc. Always, this we have seen earlier also, life by definition is like that. So life is, a human life is like that, mixture of sukha and dukha, both will be there. And in fact, Paramarthandaji, etc., they say, so how is it? So sukham, and Pooja Swami says, dukham will last long, and sukham is just fleeting, comes and goes now and then. That is, situations are like that. So challenging situations are more than, you know, pleasant situations, and we have to take this as an ideal and, you know, try to overcome those situations and try to retain our serenity. So at the cost of talking too much, so let me end here, and we will meet again on perhaps Friday. Om yatra yatra raghunatha darshan yatra yatra raghunatha kirtanam tatra tatra kata mastakanjalim bashpavari paripurna lochanam marutim namata rakshasantakam om purnamadah purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva avashishyate om shanti 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 harihi om shri gurubhyo namaha harihi om tatsat shri ramarpanamastu.